Christine Martin lived every girl's dream. The newest clothes, the coolest shoes, and money to burn.
I was used to having very, very nice things, and things actually had a hold on me. It was a matter of the thing and the home and the nice car and the country club or the yachts or the, you know, driving around in beautiful things with your windows down so people could see you.
But behind the country clubs and privileged lifestyle, Christine was living a nightmare.
The molestation happened from the ages from 3 to 13, so it would happen in a very long time of my life. It was forceful and not pleasant. Yeah, it was just really embarrassing and continual, nonstop.
The abuse came from not one, but two men in her extended family. But Christine never told a soul.
I was this inner kid inside screaming, wanting to tell somebody, please help me. But I was told, do not say anything, do not tell your parents, no one is to know, this is our secret.
While the physical abuse eventually stopped, the emotional pain only got worse.
I was very, very damaged, very hurting, very broken, lonely, insignificant. I felt that no one wanted me.
And just when she thought she couldn't feel any lower, she was raped at a party by a stranger when she was 16.
I had this horrible, disgusting, dirty feeling relived all over again, and this horrible, dark stillness just captivated every part of me. I sat in the shower and almost made myself bleed. You know, I scrubbed so hard and scratched my body and pulled my hair out at scalp. I just wanted to get every part that he had touched off me and away from me. I told one girlfriend, and she's like, oh, you better keep it quiet, you know. This is a good school and your parents, and you don't want to make a fuss. So I kept it quiet.
Then her father lost his contracting business. She couldn't hide her pain behind a lavish lifestyle. And she used other things, drugs, alcohol, and promiscuity to mask her pain.
I did not have any value for myself as a woman. A body was just, you know, there's no respect for it. It's already been taken advantage of, so why does it matter to give it away? I would do drugs every single weekend, and whenever I could, almost several times during the week, I'd smoke pot, I would get high, I would skip school.
But all that changed one day when she was 19. She had been joyriding with a friend.
I lost control of my car, and my car had spun in 360s for about 50 yards. And I remember my car teetering over the edge of the bridge. I thought, oh my God, I'm gonna die with the fish. You know, I didn't think about clothes, I didn't think about people, I didn't think about family. I cried out and said, dear God, please rescue me. That's all I remember uttering. And I remember as my car was on fire, teetering over this bridge, a huge, I know it was an angelic presence, about five stories tall, massive, wide in stature, just strong and gray like, took my car, and it was like these hands almost swooped down like this and took my car and teetered it right off the bridge onto the grass. My car door flung open, and I just remember rolling out and laying on the grass.
While she was there, she thought about the angel that set her car to safety. Then she remembered going to church as a child and knew it was finally time to give her heart to Jesus.
And there was this uncommon peace that I had not ever known that had come over my body and swept over my soul. And I felt for the first time in my life that I was valuable, that someone cared about this girl, that I was gonna be okay. And that day radically transformed my life. And it's like I fell in love with this Jesus that everyone had talked about, but I had never known. He became so real to me on that particular day, just as real as I'm talking about him now, that I knew that all the pain and all the tragedy and everything that I had gone through, you know, maybe was not in vain, because at 19, there was still a purpose for my life, and I wasn't gonna be some washed up druggie, you know, whisking life away and using people the rest of her life.
Christine is married now and has a wonderful son, Solomon. She and her husband love to share what Christ has done in their lives.
My life is amazing. I know it's because I know who I am in Christ, that Jesus has become literally my friend. He's so real to me. He is the fiber of why I do what I do, why I breathe, why I live, why I exist. It is all because God showed me grace.